Hello everyone, here is a new video of our chapter Kingdom Classification. Let us start with Kingdom Plantae. Whenever you see a plant, first of all, what you notice? You notice that plant is green in color. Green in color means they will perform photosynthesis and they will prepare their own food. So let us see what are the points coming under Kingdom Plantae. First of all, they are multicellular organism made up of more than one cell. Autotrophic in nature means they prepare their own food. They prepare their own food by the process called photosynthesis. They are green in color because of the pigment called chlorophyll. They have a cell wall which is made up of cellulose. They are divided into five classes. Let us see what are these five classes. First is thallophyta. Second is bryophyta. Third is pteridophyta. Fourth is gymnosperm. And fifth is angiosperm. Thallophyta means the organisms like algae which do not have a distinct root and shoot system. Bryophyta means they have a root and shoot system, but shoot system doesn't have leaves, stem, flowers, anything. Pteridophyta means the organisms which have leaves and stem, but they do not have flowers. Gymnosperm means the seed which are not covered by fruit. And the last come angiosperm, the plants which have fruits as well as seeds within them. So here are the classes of Kingdom Plantae. Okay, then coming to the next kingdom, that is Kingdom Animalia. Now what are animals? As by seeing the animals, you can find out that the animals are multicellular. They are heterotrophic in nature, means they do not prepare their own food. They are dependent upon others for their food. Absence of cell wall. As in plant cells, cell wall is present, but in animal cell wall is absent. They are divided into two groups, vertebrates and invertebrates. Vertebrates means what? Organisms which have backbone. And invertebrates which do not have backbone. So the vertebrates and the invertebrates, like human beings, they come under vertebrates because they have a backbone. Insects come under invertebrates because they do not have a backbone. Okay, so these are the structures and examples of Kingdom Animalia. Now let us see how our animals are classified, how organisms are classified, how plants are classified. There is a system which is known as classification system, a general plan of classification. If you can see here in this picture, you can see that there is a flow chart that mentions that first is your kingdom. Kingdom consists of animals which have a little bit of similar characteristics. Okay, then the organisms coming under kingdom, if they have the similar characteristics, they will be placed in phylum. Then from in phylum, when the phylum is then divided into various classes, one class will be divided into various orders. One order will be divided into many families. One family will be divided into genus and then into species. Now this is the smallest, or we can say the category in which more and more similarities we can find. If we take the example of human being come under one species. We are not same as gorilla or we are not same as apes. Apes have different species. We are different species. Okay, so this way species means they contain the same type of organism. Okay, now here are some descriptions of these terms. First is kingdom. Kingdom is the highest rank. Then comes phylum. One kingdom is divided into many phyla based on similarities. Class. Organism and phylum are grouped into various classes. Order. Each class is divided into subgroups known as orders. Family. Each order is divided into many families. Genus. Organisms are divided into genera, species, individual membranes capable of producing offsprings, means they will reproduce and they can produce their own type, means they can give birth to their new individuals. Okay, so these are the terms related to classification system. Now let us see one example. If we want to classify tiger, okay, this is a tiger. If we want to classify them, first comes your kingdom. Kingdom, to which kingdom it belongs? It belongs to Animalia. Under kingdom Animalia, it is divided into chordata, as I said, vertebrates and invertebrates. So they will be coming under chordata, means they have a backbone. Okay, then class. Chordata can again be divided into many classes, like it can be amphibia, it can be reptilia, it can be birds. Okay, so they are coming under mammals, means they give birth to the young ones. Under mammal also many types come, like mammals can be carnivores, it can be omnivores, it can be herbivores. So tigers are carnivora, so we have kept it under carnivora. Now under that comes family. Family is Felidae. And then genus is Panthera, species is Tigris. Okay, so this is how we classify the living organism. This is one example. The same way you can classify other organisms. Okay, and that makes us very easy to read or to study any animals, what type of animals they are. We can, now you can see we are mentioning like this is the identity of this organism, like this animal, this is animal, this is chordata, this is mammalia, this is carnivora, Felidae, Panthera, Tigris. So these all are the characteristics of this tiger. Okay, now next coming to how we should write a name, or we can call it a scientific name of any organism. First of all, let us understand what is binomial system of nomenclature. Binomial nomenclature are made up of certain words. What are the meanings of words? We will see now. Bi means two. Nomial means name, means the name will contain two words. Now, nomenclature means naming system. This is the naming of any organism. We can call it as nomenclature. Okay, so how we can write the nomenclature? First point is the name of species consists of two parts, that is genus and species. Like you have seen here that genus was written just at the bottom part, genus and species. So the names will contain Panthera and Tigris. Together it will give the name of this organism. The same thing is going on here. You can see that it contains of two parts, genus and species. First part, the first letter is in capital, but the whole are in small letter. The second part is also written in small letters. If it is written, it should be underlined, and if it is typed, it should be printed in italics. Like the example which I have given here, you can see Homo sapiens. Homo sapiens are the is the scientific name of human being, in which you have seen it has been typed. Suppose it has been typed anywhere in a computer or in your system, it has been typed, or it is typed, it was printed in the book. It should be written in italics. This is the italics font. Okay, so it should be written in this way. So this is the first letter, which is written in capital, and rest all are in small. And in the next one, you can see, suppose this is handwritten, we are writing it. So how we should write? We should write it and then we should underline the two words in this way. So here also what I have done, the first letter should be capital and the rest should be written in small. So this is how we should write any scientific name of any organism. Suppose we are writing a Panthera tigris. So how you will write? Panthera, Panthera, tigris, tigris. This way we will write, and we will underline it. As I have written it, I will underline the two words where the first letter is in capital and rest all are in small. And if I have written, I will underline these two words. Okay, so here we have completed our chapter. In next video, I'll be discussing the question answers. Till then, you also try to find out the question answers. Okay.